Namaskara. As I drove to ITC this evening, I was thinking of this Kannada poem penned by a, we call him Rashtra Kavi, national poet, who's no longer with us. But this is a poem that perhaps every artist can identify with. I'll just recite one or two verses. Perhaps Meenaji will connect most with it, while all of us do, because I think today even business has become art. If you are not creative, then you don't get too far in the corporate world. I will just recite one or two verses. He says, "Yella kelali yendu nanu haaduvudilla, haaduvudu anivarya karma nanage, tanu tumbi yede tumbi mana tumbi haaduvenu." Which means that I don't sing because I want everyone to be listening to me. I sing because that's all I know. I think each artist that does that, and art really in that sense is the expression of the free spirit, and it's boundless and seamless. You can't really put it in a frame. However, there are people like Meenaji who manage to do it with the brush. A lot of us have difficulty even writing a few words legibly these days because we are so used to our computers and typing. Even writing is such an art now. To be rendering all of this for us to see and to buy, I think is indeed such a wonderful thing to do and such a wonderful way of giving back to the society. I was just thinking, I was wondering, and I always wonder when you look at these images of God, when you look at these sculptures, you know, you see a Ganesha with five faces, Panchamukha Ganesha, or you see Murugan or Subramanya with six faces, and then you see Devi sitting on the lion with 12 arms, you know, each one adorning a weapon, and you wonder if all this is just a myth. And then you see women like Meenaji, you know, she does so many different things, so many facets she has. Like he was saying earlier, she runs this, she edits this wonderful magazine called Gulf Connoisseur. And then she invited me to this dance that she curated, a performance, a ballet performance that she curated last month through their Kathakali club. And it was so wonderful. It was this, you know, it was an explosion of music and dance and joy. And then there was a story, there was romance, there was anger. It was Chilapadikaram, which she had chosen so carefully. And then you turn around and look at her. She's a mother, she's a wife, she's a wonderful daughter. I think all of us know of that. And then she writes, and then she makes films and wins awards. And then you look at her and she does all of this. And so it is possible for one person to do so many different things. And after all, I think the purpose of all of our lives is to enrich the other. And she does it in her own way, actually in so many different ways. It's an honor to be here with her and amidst all of you and with all this lovely work of art. I think art is meant to be just savored and enjoyed without uttering anything. So less said the better. So it's just for us to look. And she says four seasons, and a woman and various moods of a woman, of how her life begins with innocence and then slowly a small understanding of the world, then the sense of comfort, and then the sense of letting go, you know. Ultimately, I think that's what it is, to earn everything and then to learn to let go. I am reminded of yet another poem of K.S. Narasimha Swami, where he speaks about the first 3 days in a bride's life. Modaladina Mauna, he says, on the very first day in the groom's house, she's very quiet, she's silent. On the next day, you hear her footsteps. On the third day, she's, you know, throwing herself in joy with a lot of jasmine in her hair. So it's like that. I think for all of us, life is like that. And here, her work reflects life. I wish Meenaji many more such exhibitions. It's not easy to do a solo art exhibition, I'm sure. A lot of you know more about art than I do. I am an artist. So to enjoy art takes people like you. And thank you so much for inviting me this evening. I wish you many more such exhibitions. Thanks.
ಮಾತೇನಿದೆ ನೀನು?